Good evening, and welcome to the Baccalaureate for the class of 2024. My name is Jade Beeler. I serve as the assistant principal at Spencer High School. I also serve in the Wisconsin Army National Guard, and I'm proud to be here tonight and welcome you here to our program. Please stand. God in heaven, it is our privilege to invite you here as the guest of honor for Baccalaureate 2024. It is our request that you would bless this graduating class, but more than that, and of first importance, we desire that you would be here with us this evening. I ask on behalf of those gathered here that you would be indeed bless each of these graduates. Give the grace to make a difference for the good wherever they may find themselves in the years ahead. Father, thank you so much for helping them to become energetic, enthusiastic, and passionate Christians while on the road to their adulthood. For all of us, we ask that you empower our witness, bless our service, and keep our hearts pure as we grow and mature in our faith in you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Please respond to each prayer intention with, "Hear our prayer." Almighty God, creator of life and source of all truth, we ask your blessing for all the graduates of 2024. Lord, in thy mercy, keep them alert in spirit and loyal to the truth. Preserve them from faithless impatience, from pride and laziness, and from doing any unworthy work in your name. Lord, in thy mercy. When we go astray, correct us. When we are corrupted through prejudice, pride, or selfishness, awaken our consciences that we may amend our ways. And when we fail, give us courage to begin again. Lord, in thy mercy. Go forth with us as we pursue our dreams, seek adventure, accept new responsibilities, and discover ourselves. Lord, in thy mercy. Bless all who have taught and encouraged us through the days of our youth. Bless our families, pastors, and teachers, counselors, mentors, and friends, and you, Lord, who have given us true guidance and continual support. Lord, in thy mercy. At this time, I invite the graduating seniors who have dedicated their vocation of service for our country to please come up front for a special blessing. The four seniors that are graduating this year, we have Tyler Heinrichs and Lewis Volk here tonight. Also, Connor Inman will be joining the military, or has joined the military. He's in training right now. And also Nick Inslee. At this, for our prayer, watch over those who answer the call to service in the armed forces. Keep them safe from all evil, and do them with courage and loyalty, and grant that in all things that they may serve without reproach. O Lord, bless these service members and graduates. Purify their motives and their goals, and give them a measure of usefulness and purpose in the world which you have made and redeemed. And the busy world, support us all the long day until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes, and the busy world is hushed, and the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then in your mercy, grant us safe lodging, and a holy rest, and peace at last. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. If you are a military guest here this evening, please be recognized, and go ahead and show us who you are. Go ahead and raise your hand. All right, let's give them a round of applause. We thank all who have served and going to serve, and honor them, those who will protect us. Thank you. Please be seated.
Good evening. My name is Rochelle Achenbaugh. I am a high school English teacher here, and I am the proud homeroom advisor to a group of seniors. In fact, this is my third group of seniors, so you start to think about skipping through time a little bit here. But I am thrilled to be here and honored to talk about the 2024 Baccalaureate theme, which is Psalm 33, verses 20 to 22. We wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. In him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in his holy name. May your unfailing love be with us, Lord, even as we put our hope in you. This scripture reminds us to depend on God, for he is everything we need. What's more, our hearts overflow with joy by taking his holy name and living his word. May we always continue trusting in the Lord, for we can rest in his word, we can rest in his will, and we can rest in his watching. As our trust in him deepens, our ability to rest in him grows. And when we are resting in him, we can rejoice in spite of everything that is going on around us. We serve a God who is worthy to be praised. He deserves the uninhibited praises of his people. He deserves our best songs and our loudest shouts and our devoted service. He is worthy to be praised, and we are way behind in the business of praising him, however. We allow other things to cloud our thinking and hide his face. So may every day we take a fresh look at our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we might be filled with praise for him. Has the Lord touched you in some area of your life? Are you praising him like he deserves? Have you become distracted by some issue so that you have lost your focus on him? Do you need to thank him for his word, his will, and his watching? Do you need to bring some sin to him in repentance? Do you need to seek his help in some matter? Do you need to come before him and seek him in worship? If he has spoken to you on any level, please mind him and let him have his way in your heart and life. In his name, we pray that you love us, God, with all you've got. That's what we are depending on. Father, it is right to call you glorious and good because that is what you are. It is right to sing songs about how great you are because that is true. You are in complete control and you take care of me. You are my Savior and you promise to use all things for the good of your people. You've shown your willingness to do this by sending your Son to die for me. Help me to trust in you and hope in your love today. Amen.
Good evening, everyone. I am Michelle Gibson. And when I started 4 years ago teaching geometry in 2021, some of these very students were assigned to my homeroom as freshmen. So I am here today to celebrate with you and worship God. Please stand and respond after each scripture verse. Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Father, thank you for the gift of singing. Praising you in song, praising you with joy is appropriate. It is right to sing of how great you are. It is right to praise your name. Let my joy in you continue to grow, and please keep showing me how great you are so that my praise might increase. Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Your word is good and true because you are good and true. Everything you do is an expression of your faithful love. In love, you make all things, and in love, you sustain all things. Only you have the power to create and sustain all things. I praise you for how great you are, for it is right to do so. Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. People, make plans, yet it is your will that endures. People make evil plans, and yet you restrain so much evil. Praise you for your kindness. Thank you for letting me be a part of your people. Thank you for saving us in Christ and making us your heritage. There is no greater life than living with you. When trouble comes and heartaches occur, help me remember that you are good and in control of everything. Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Dearest Lord, you are in complete control, not me. And that is terrific news. I know there are many ways that I trust in the securities of life in order to bring me safety. But those things cannot save me. Only you can save me. You are in charge of all, and you specially watch out for me because I am your child. You care for me and for all who hope in your steadfast love. Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Lord, you are my protection and my help. I trust in you, and my heart finds joy in you. Let your steadfast love be upon your people today as we put our hope in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
My name is Maria Fonlander.
And I'm Jackie Bryan.
And I teach high school math, and Jackie teaches vocal music. And it's been an honor to be able to teach many of you academically and musically. And on behalf of Jackie and myself, we are so honored to be a part of tonight, to not only have helped you grow in knowledge, but also to emphasize that we're a part of your faith family as well. And so we have these pieces of advice that we ask you to offer as a prayer and to keep in mind to take with you during this last week of high school and also beyond. Fellow Christian graduates of 2024, life is too short. Grudges are a waste of perfect happiness. Laugh when you can, apologize when you should, and let go of what you can. Take chances. Give everything and have no regrets. Life is too short to be unhappy. You have to take the good with the bad. Smile when you're sad. Love what you've got and always remember what you've had. Always forgive, but never forget. Learn from your mistakes, but never regret. People change and things go wrong, but always remember life goes on. As your road takes you on new travels in life, here are a few thoughts to take along.
Have faith in a personal God. The happiest people in the world are not the wealthy or famous, not the scientists or men with high positions. Happy people are those who found their hope in God, not only for this world, but including the world beyond.
Don't hold grudges. Happy people understand that it's better to forgive and forget than to let their negative feelings take over positive feelings. Holding a grudge has a lot of bad effects on your well-being. Why let anyone who has wronged you ever have power over you? If you let go of all of your grudges, you'll gain a clear conscience and enough energy to enjoy the good things in life.
Treat everyone with kindness. Did you know that it has been scientifically proven that being kind makes you happier? Every time you perform a selfless act, your brain produces serotonin, a hormone that eases tension and lifts your spirit. Not only that, but treating people with love, dignity, and respect also allows you to build stronger relationships.
See problems as challenges. The word problem is never a part of a happy person's vocabulary. A problem is viewed as a drawback, a struggle, or an unstable situation, while a challenge is viewed as something positive, like an opportunity, a task, or desire. Whenever you face an obstacle, try looking at it as a challenge.
Express gratitude for what you already have. There's a popular saying that goes something like this: the happiest people don't have the best of everything, they just make the best of everything they have. You will have a deeper sense of contentment if you count your blessings instead of longing for what you don't have.
Speak well of others. Being nice feels better than being mean. As fun as gossiping is, it usually leaves you feeling guilty and resentful. Saying nice things about other people encourages you to think positively and have non-judgmental thoughts.
Never make excuses. Benjamin Franklin once said, "He that is good for making excuses is seldom good for anything else." Happy people don't make excuses or blame others for their own failures in life. Instead, they own up to their mistakes, and by doing so, they proactively try to change for the better.
Get absorbed in the present. Happy people don't dwell on the past or worry about the future. They savor the present. They let themselves get immersed in whatever they're doing at the moment. So remember to stop and smell the roses.
Take the time to listen. Talk less, listen more. Listening keeps your mind open to others' wisdoms and outlooks on the world. The more intensely you listen, the quieter your mind gets and the more content you feel.
Tell the truth. Lying stresses you out. It corrodes your self-esteem and makes you unlikable. The truth will set you free. Being honest improves your mental health and it builds others' trust in you. Always be truthful and never apologize for it.
Accept what you cannot change. Once you accept the fact that life is not fair, you'll be more at peace with yourself. Instead of obsessing over how unfair life is, just focus on what you can control and change it for the better.
As brothers and sisters in Christ, let us challenge ourselves and one another today, tomorrow, and beyond. Let's unite to stand on the side of good, love each other with genuine affection, and make the time to let God be the center of our lives.
Hello, my name is Glenn Grettinger, and I am fortunate enough this year to be the school counselor for the class of 2024. At this time, I would ask all the parents of the class of 2024 to please stand for the parents' prayer and extend your hand over the class for a special parent blessing. Seniors, please bow your heads and listen to the words that are prayed over you by your parents who love you so. Dear Lord, please bless these graduates as they go out into the world to make it a better place while they pursue their dreams. Gently guide them, lead them, show them your way to success and happiness through service to others as they maximize their own potential. Fill them with joy when they reach their goals. Strengthen them as they deal with life's obstacles and show them that every challenge is a path to character development. Give them the intelligence to make a plan for their futures. Give them the patience and persistence to pursue their ambitions. Most of all, give them caring hearts to look for ways to help the people they meet on their life's journey. Encourage them and lift them up now as they spread their wings into a clear sky of limitless opportunity. Let each and every graduate here be wrapped in the warmth of your infinite love, and let your wisdom show them the way to truly live their lives for your promise of everlasting love. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Everyone, please be seated.
I'm Linda Forster, the attendance administrative assistant, and I just want to say it's been a pleasure working with all of you, watching you grow, and telling you to have a good afternoon as you leave for an appointment or arrive at school during the day.
I'm Amy Gronemeyer. I'm the administrative assistant to Dr. Doble, and I personally want to wish the class of 2024 the best in their future endeavors.
The flowers in the sanctuary are in memory of Ellie Weimers, wife, mother, teacher, and friend to all, Scott Reddy, teacher, career teacher, and longtime coach, Ryan Carpenter, father of Connor Carpenter and Haley Carpenter, Michael Rohan, son of Kevin and Susan, and 2024 classmate, Anna Hamrick, sister of Javin Hamrick, David Haviland, father of Braden Haviland, Mark Cayley, father of Sadie Cayley, Brady Lynch, father of Wesley Lynch, Daisy Mae Raycotts, sister of Jersey Norgard, along with all our loved ones who are not here with us today. Those who we love remain with us, for love itself lives on. Cherished memories never fade because a loved one is gone. Those we love can never be more than a thought apart. For as long as there is a memory, they'll live on in our heart.
Please bow your heads in this moment of prayer. In those quiet moments in the still of the night, remember to rejoice and celebrate life. Do not think of me gone and weep. I am not there. I do not sleep.
I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond glints on the snow. I am the sunlight on the grain. I am the gentle autumn's rain.
When you awaken in the morning hush, I am the swift uplifting rush. I'm the quiet birds in flight. I'm also the soft stars that shine at night.
You will hear my gentle voice, so always be ready to rejoice. Never give up your fight, and always remember to celebrate life. Amen.
We wait in the hope of the Lord. He is our help and our shield. In him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in his holy name. May your unfailing love be with us, Lord, even as we put our hopes in you. Dear Heavenly Father, there are so many troubles to wear us down, yet we know you are there to lean on. Guide us as we tackle one issue after another with the confidence that you are in charge. Let us love each other as brothers and sisters in Christ. May your life goal be to get one another to heaven, as that is the ultimate reward of our life here on earth. Amen.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Terry Heeman. I'm the superintendent of schools. And as I'm sitting here thinking, I've been here for, this is my 13th year. You were kindergartners my first year when I came. You look a lot different now. I have the honor tonight of introducing our guest speakers, and it is truly an honor to introduce both Dave and Sarah Schmidt tonight. Dave and Sarah are both Spencer School employees. They're part of our Spencer School's family. Dave is a fourth grade teacher and has been at Lincoln Elementary since 2011. He's a wonderful teacher. If your child has had him, if you've had him, you know what I'm talking about. He's a great man. Sarah is a Spencer School graduate of the class of 1998. It's in the book. And started her dream job as a school nurse at the high school in 2021. And all I've seen her do in her time as a school nurse is love and care for our kids each and every day. They have two wonderful sons that graduated from Spencer High School, Sam in 2021 and Cale last year, 2023. They love the Spencer community and all that it has to offer, as well as appreciate all the love and support the people of Spencer show to each other. They also enjoy all of the love and support. They also enjoy all of the activities there are to do outside in the area and family-friendly events, especially the Clay County Fair and the Grand Meander. I want to thank Dave and Sarah for making this a special night for our 2024 graduates.
Thank you, Mr. Heeman, for the introduction tonight. I'm honored to be asked to share these words. Dave and I have been working at the Spencer Schools, and we just love working together and being able to be with you kids. Dave's here as my backup because you all know I may not make it through this speech, but he'll take over if needed. I just wanted to get started by saying how proud I am of each and every one of you seniors. I've been blessed with getting to know you each over the past year, and I will definitely miss you as you graduate from Spencer High School. I'm very excited to see where your journey goes with God's plans for each of you unfold. I'm sure new seniors and your parents alike are experiencing many different emotions during this time of year, saying goodbye to the last, but also looking forward to the new. Of course, there's excitement, anticipation, and happiness. But there's also some nervousness, and maybe some anxiety, and possibly some fear. I want you to know all of those feelings are normal and okay to be feeling. Tonight I'd like to share a scripture passage I found in Psalms 33:20-22 with you today, as well as some of my personal story. Psalms 33:20-22 says, "Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. For in him our hearts rejoice. In his holy name we trust. May your mercy, Lord, be upon us as we put our hope in you." I would like to encourage you to think about these words as I share the role they've played in my life, especially this past year. The key words from the passage that I want you to focus on as I share my story are wait, help, shield, rejoice, trust, mercy, and hope. On the first day of Christmas break in December 22, I had a delicious cherry donut to celebrate the start of Christmas break. After that wonderful donut, I just didn't feel very good, and it lasted for quite a while. And for those of you that don't know, I was a surgical nurse at the hospital for 20 years before becoming a school nurse. So my first thought was it must be my gallbladder. I needed it to be taken out. So I went to the doctor, and they did an ultrasound to look at my gallbladder. Shortly after that appointment, I received the call that I'm sorry. There was a very large tumor on my pancreas, and I was going to be sent to Mayo Clinic in Rochester. I was in the hospital there for a few days, and then on January 11, 2023, I was officially diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. It took my breath away. Of course, there was the first feeling of disbelief, and along with disbelief came the feeling of fear. The team of doctors from Mayo told me that it's not a good diagnosis, and that the plan was to do chemotherapy and then have surgery to remove my tumor. I was scared, but I liked to have a plan, so it was good to have a plan, and I went to my first round of chemotherapy, but but I had a bad allergic reaction to one of the medications. The reaction to the medication instantly closed my airway and I couldn't breathe. Thankfully, the doctors were able to get that under control. I had ended up being able to do all 12 rounds of chemotherapy, which is the maximum you can have of that type of medication. Throughout the treatments, there were times my labs were too low and I couldn't receive the treatment, so I had to wait, a key word in our passage. There were many times after my treatment I would be completely sick for days. I lost my hair, but that was okay. I was fighting and I was working my way to surgery. It was time for my last round of tests and scans, and I had finished my last and final round of chemo. I was ready to meet with the surgeons and on to the next step in the plan. As this meeting with the doctors, they told me the only hope of being cured of cancer, being cancer-free, was to have surgery and remove the tumor. The plan was to remove my spleen, gallbladder, stomach, pancreas, and a bunch of veins and arteries that my tumor had wrapped around. After the doctors had met and took a look at my scans, the surgeons decided that the surgery was just way too dangerous and they couldn't do it. So instead, the plan changed again, and I needed to start radiation. I started going to the Mayo Clinic for radiation for 3 weeks, and I had way less side effects than chemo, but radiation was every day instead of chemo being every other week. Thankfully, the combination of radiation and chemo worked well for me, and the tumor became non-active. However, there were 3 new spots on my liver. At this point, they were very concerned that the cancer was spreading throughout my body. The doctor wanted me to wait for 2 months. The plan was for me to have my next appointment after Christmas of this past year. Boy, did we have a good Christmas. When I went to that appointment, my liver spots were gone. And now in my life, my tumor on my pancreas is considered under control. The doctors are currently watching the area between my colon and bladder, but they have said the disappearing spots in my liver are something that they have never seen before. They called it a miracle. The doctor said, "You must have a lot of people praying for you." And I said, so I'm here today to thank you all for praying for me. I'm sure you can imagine all the emotions I've been having this past year. After hearing the doctors call it a miracle brings me back to the keywords I challenge you to think about: wait, help, shield, rejoice, trust, mercy, and hope. Our soul waits for the Lord. Be patient. I certainly understand waiting to get things done and lacking patience in my life. Having patience is hard. Yes, I'm hungry and waiting for my food at a restaurant type of patience, but then there is another level of patience that's not possible without having a relationship with God. This is the type of patience only with God when you hear the news that the doctors say, "We see spots in your liver and we are sure your cancer is spreading, but you have to wait and come back in 2 months to check." The patience only comes from knowing God is walking with you through this. I'm thankful that I know God. If I didn't know God as my Lord and Savior and did not have a relationship with Him, I know my anxiety would have overwhelmed me and it would have been hard to keep pushing through. So my challenge to you seniors, as you go forward from Spencer High School towards your next step of the journey in life, remember patience. Things will happen as God plans for you. He hears your prayers. He listens to you when you pray. He also knows the best time and way to respond to you. It's all good to be still sometimes. Remember to wait. He is our help and our shield. He will not fail you. He will protect you. For my life, I don't know what God has planned for me here on earth, and that is okay. He is helping me through every day and has blessed me with this opportunity to share my story and faith with all of you. So as you leave here today, remember God is our greatest protector. Remember that doesn't mean things will be easy for you or you will understand everything He has planned for your life. He will protect you. Will you still worry? Yes. Will there still be troubles in your future? Of course. But remember, God has you in His arms and He will protect you. For in Him, our hearts rejoice. There is always some way to celebrate the joy that brings into your life. For me, this joy is what I find with you. You students bring me joy and energy every single day. I love to hear your stories. I love seeing you laugh. I love the excitement that it brings to our halls and classrooms of our building. So stop and look for joy in your life. There is always something to be joyful for. For example, there is nothing like seeing the sunshine breaking through the clouds after a thunderstorm passes. I think that finding the joys in life and waiting for God's timing can go hand in hand many times. Slow down and appreciate that it's all around you, especially the people that provide you the most joy. In God's holy name, we trust. I really had to put trust in God. Saying it sounds simple, doing it is much more difficult at times. I challenge you tonight to remember to trust God. Give him your troubles and your worries. It is hard not to try and control things or plan what will happen. As our journey from here continues, trust that things will work out and you will be okay. Be open to trying new things and taking new opportunities. Trust God. Our God is loving, forgiving, and compassionate. I ask you to try to find these same traits in yourself. Let people know you love them and be open to forgiving people if they hurt you. Try to forgive them without stipulations. Be compassionate to all living things. Show empathy to people. Help each other and be open to receiving help when you need it. Think of the difference you could all make with more love, forgiveness, compassion, and empathy. As we put our hope in God, never lose hope. Miracles do happen. I ask you to keep your hope as you go through life for things big and small. Right now, there is an excitement in the air and you're hopeful for your futures. Keep that excitement going as you continue on your journey. In closing, remember our key words: wait, help, shield, rejoice, trust, mercy, and hope. Not only are these words important to value in your everyday life, be patient with people, help each other, protect each other, celebrate each other, trust each other, show mercy to each other, and share hope with each other, but also keep them in the forefront of your relationship with God. I'm so very proud of each and one of you, and I look forward to hearing about all your journeys. Remember, the hardest part of the journey is the first step. If you aren't sure where to start, it's really okay. You can just start by talking to God when you're alone. He is always there to listen. Spencer High School class of 2024, I love you, and God has you in his hands.
Thank you. My name is Lisa DeWitt, and I'm the other school counselor. So I've had a lot of you since you were little kids and have had the opportunity to kind of loop with you. I was an elementary school counselor, so it's a blessing to see all of you so grown up. Please stand as we say the closing prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, there are times when we find ourselves at the crossroads of decision, sometimes not knowing which path to take, when to move, whether to go left or right. A lot of times we choose our own paths, go our own way, and we don't wait for God, our shepherd, to lead or guide us into paths of righteousness. We must be reminded that God knows the way that we take. We must trust God in every situation of our lives to fulfill our petitions and to unfold his will for our lives. May we always love each other as brothers and sisters, be tender-hearted, and keep a humble attitude. Don't repay evil for evil. Don't retaliate with insults when people insult you. Instead, pay them back with a blessing. Let's unite to stand on the side of the good. Love each other with genuine affection and carry another's burden with a goal of helping others and ourselves with the ultimate reward of heaven. Amen. So seniors, I ask you, what difference will you make in this world? What legacy do you want to leave behind for those who will follow behind? The greatest compliment would be to be remembered as the class of 2024 who truly love God and will forever walk in his ways. On behalf of myself and all those who came tonight, taking this blessed opportunity to share their personal faith and love for God, we all wish you the very best.
Sometimes the load is heavy, and sometimes the road is long, and sometimes, Lord, this heart of mine is not so very strong, but the ask you to take
We now ask that you give each other a sign of peace.
Seniors, please stand. Here are some final thoughts for the class of 2024. Don't forget. Forget about the days when it's been cloudy.
But don't forget about your hours in the sun.
Forget about the times you have been defeated.
But don't forget the victories you've won.
Forget about mistakes that you can't change now.
But don't forget the lessons that you've learned.
Forget about misfortunes you've encountered.
But don't forget the times your luck has turned.
Forget about the days when you've been lonely.
But don't forget the friendly smiles you've seen.
Forget about the plans that didn't seem work out right.
But don't forget to always have a dream. SHS senior class of 2024, from today on, continue to live by the class scripture. We wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. In him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in his holy name. May your unfailing love be with us, Lord, even as we put our hope in you.
Be remembered as the class of 2024, who carry one another's burdens and fulfill the law of Christ. Always shout for joy, have a forgiving heart, love all fellow brothers and sisters, and worship the Lord with gladness and pride.
Continue to stay strong on who you are and never forget where you came from. Remember, your village is always looking forward to your return. God will carry you, and we will always have you close to our hearts in thoughts and prayers. Amen.
Thank you for coming to our 2024 Baccalaureate service. Everyone is welcome to a reception in the parish hall. Please stand and join in our closing song.
Shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak if you stand.